Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Proud of Badass Media Productions Season 5. So in this episode I'm going to be looking back at Evil Dead, released way back in 1981, and why I feel it's the best of the franchise, in my opinion. One night I decided to watch Evil Dead, and the next night I decided to watch Evil Dead 2. And watching the two back to back, it kind of made me appreciate the first film a little bit more than Evil Dead 2. Don't get me wrong, Evil Dead 2 is a fantastic, wonderful sequel that's very creative, and the dark humor really, really works. I love the use of effects. The practical effects in that movie is flawless. The genuine gore effects are much better. The makeup effects in the Deadeye, also a big improvement. The way Ash's character is changed, and it really suits Bruce Campbell's performance because it really shows his comic side, and it's changed his character forever to the character that we truly, truly love in, of course, Ash vs. the Evil Dead. But I just feel that the first film always edges it over Evil Dead 2. I feel the first film is just a flawless horror movie. It's a horror movie that does so much for the horror genre. Sam Raimi done a lot of short movies before he done Evil Dead. Evil Dead is considered his directorial debut, and it's amazing how much he done for that film. He was like 20 years old when he directed that movie, but the techniques he used in that film, they were not techniques like an amateur would use. Evil Dead had a tiny budget, a pretty small budget, and today's standard, if someone tried to shoot a horror movie with Evil Dead's budget, it would have been one of those found footage shaky cam films. That's what it would have been. But Sam Raimi, he didn't do that. He chose to actually make something bigger, better, more impressive in scale. He didn't have the budget, but he sure as hell had the passion. That's why Evil Dead works so much. From the very beginning of Evil Dead, there is a sense of tension. There's a sense of evil. Even before the words from the book is recited, there is a sense of evil always present, and it's always lingering. And Sam Raimi, he nails that presence from the very beginning of the film. It's incredible seeing someone that young be able to portray that so well. The first half hour of the film is just pure world building, tension building, and it's so wonderfully done. Just a sense of atmosphere from the very, very beginning. There's something wrong. You can tell that something is going to happen to this wonderful group of people, but you don't know when it's going to happen. But Sam Raimi does it so well. Seeing Cheryl, how she reacts in the cabin is wonderfully creepy and truly disturbing. Seeing her draw the buck uncontrollably, it's so wonderfully terrifying. Just that presence is just incredible. Once the recording is discovered in the basement of the cabin, the scene is so iconic. Hearing that wonderful recording play out, the words being recited, and seeing Cheryl's reaction towards it, it plays off each other like a perfect leitmotif. Two tracks playing off each other to create this wonderful, tense scene. It's incredible. Of course, Cheryl runs off, she gets attacked by the woods. That scene where she gets attacked by a tree, it's so unique and iconic. Scene that has so much creativity in the horror genre. And of course, we get that wonderful scene in which we see the Deadeye for the first time. And the way it's done is so well. The build-up to it is so perfect. How it plays off, how it starts off, how we see Cheryl slowly predict cards, and her voice slowly changing as she predicts every single card. Her head spinning around, seeing her Deadeye face. It's such a wonderful introduction to this demonic force. Seeing the iconic pencil scene, that still, even today, still makes me cringe. And that's pretty effective, considering how old that film is and considering how effects have changed. But yet, that's the pencil scene still makes me cringe with horror. One of the things I have to talk about is the character of Scott. I feel Scott was one of the most underrated characters in that movie. Scott is what we do see Ash almost become in Evil Dead 2. He's almost a light version of the Ash that we love. He's a strong character. He's a character who's funny. He's got an incredible amount of willpower. He knows how to make the right decisions, depending knowing how horrible these decisions are. And this is kind of a loose, almost light version of the Ash that we've seen in Evil Dead 2. Bruce Campbell's performance as Ash, it's still a very good performance. It's much more low-key to his performance in Evil Dead 2. He plays a performance more of a straight guy, but yet there is still hints of a funny, witty character in his performance in Evil Dead 1. Seeing his care and love for his girlfriend, it plays out really well in a very cool and subtle way. Just the camera angles, the camera work in that movie is just incredible. The wonderful kind of tracking, kind of aerial shots of just the car follows through the forest as it slowly moves towards the cabin is just so wonderfully done. The kind of low angle shots of Scott as he slowly walks towards the cabin door, it's fantastically done. It's a wonderful panning shot as Ash walks down towards the basement. The camera work in this film is so stylish. Of course, I have to mention the wonderful kind of POV shots, the point of view shots of the force of pure evil. Those shots are absolutely incredible. It's a film that actually does a really good job with sound design as well. From the hearing the recording of the first time is chilling to the bone. Hearing those words being recited, terrifying. Hearing just that force of invisible evil entity surfacing and glooming around the cabin is also terrifying, and one of the most unique sounds we've heard in the horror genre. This reeks the sounds of the dead acts as they get stabbed, as they cry out in pain, chilling to the bone. This is just an incredible movie, that really set the tone for the horror franchise and just for the Evil Dead trilogy. It's a wonderful film. If you haven't seen Evil Dead 1, I'd say go back and watch it. A lot of people say Evil Dead 2 is a remake and to avoid Evil Dead 1, but I say watch Evil Dead 1. This is the perfect definition of a great horror movie and a perfect directorial debut. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to the channel if you like what you see.